Kamala Harris is a political sycophant of the highest order. She's like a desperate dude at a bar right after last call, willing to say anything to go home with whoever's still there. The sad thing is, she's not even good at it, even though she's been doing it her entire political career.
The Heller decision could impact public safety in a way that could threaten lives across this country.
We in California have some of the strongest laws as it relates to guns in the United States.
We have the good ideas, an assault weapons ban, background checks.
It's like the right side of her mouth doesn't know what the left side of her mouth is doing. The right side of her mouth will say she supports the Second Amendment, but then the left side will quickly betray her and say that we should ban the most popular and highest selling rifle in the country, the AR-15. That's like saying she supports the First Amendment, but we should ban the internet.
That doesn't make any sense.
It's bullshit. Kamala was a prosecutor. She knows the vast majority of gun deaths are committed with handguns in our inner cities. The thing is, Harris.
I believe weapons of war have no place on our streets.
There is no reason in a civil society that we have assault weapons.
No, she can't secure the white liberal suburban mom vote talking about black kids using handguns in the ghetto. They don't give a damn about those kids, and neither does she. But she's at least smart enough not to say we should ban handguns outright. That's about the only thing both sides of her mouth agree on. She'll continue to parrot whatever she reads in her Gun Control for Dummies pamphlet that every gun controller reads from, because they all say the same thing like they're a hive mind.
Fight for common sense reforms to stop the epidemic of gun violence.
We need to have common sense gun safety laws in our country.
Never trust anyone who says common sense gun safety reform. It's like saying you're a grassroots metropolitan advertiser. No, you spin signs on a street corner wearing headphones. Stop it. There's nothing common sense about solving the issue of violence in this country. Yet these people say these exact words when pushing gun control. Think about it. Why do you need 5 words to say gun control if you're not trying to deceive people or your true intentions? That's exactly what Harris is doing.
Pass universal background checks.
Universal background checks.
Take her favorite gun ban in disguise, universal background checks. On its face, it sounds so innocent. You hear universal background checks, and fleeting thoughts of Oprah handing out 4473 forms to everyone comes to mind. But in reality, it's a Peter Pan way to create a national gun registration, which history has proven is always later used to confiscate guns when the catalyst for said gun registry doesn't do anything. Just ask the Jews of Nazi Germany how well a national gun registry worked out for them. All of these things are blatant to me, and probably to you too. The problem is, there are a bunch of people out there who are clueless on this issue. Not because they're dumb, but because they don't think about these things. So when some self-serving politician says a bunch of soft words that have the hard effect of restricting constitutional rights,
look at the autopsy photographs of those babies.
They go along with it, not realizing the real-world implications of these laws. Unfortunately, our mainstream media is nothing more than a gun-hating propaganda machine. So it's left to us to do the groundwork and inform people that don't think about this stuff and vote in people who are anti-constitution without realizing it. So share this video or my other videos or any other video preaching the truth with as many of those types of people that you know, or simply engage them in a fruitful and productive conversation about this issue. That's what we have to do, because the battle for the Second Amendment is as much, if not more, cultural battle as much as it is a political battle. And as far as I'm concerned, we can't afford to let Clinton win that battle.
I'm not here to repeal the Second Amendment.
By the way, it needs to be said, I support the Second Amendment.
I'm not here to take away your guns.